Chrome for Android is not a simplified version of Chrome. It brings to small devices the same multiprocess architecture, GPU accelerated rendering, and things like the V8 JavaScript engine optimized for ARM. You should have your Chrome experience wherever you are. So we designed Chrome for Android to collaborate with Chrome Desktop and created a continuity between both experiences.
So Chrome's Omnibox was an amazing innovation when we released it for the desktop. So for Android, we wanted to ensure that it was as simple and powerful as you expect from Chrome. The Omnibox allows you to navigate to websites or to perform search queries. And as you type in the Omnibox, we provide suggestions for not only websites you may like to visit, but also items from your browsing history, as well as your local bookmarks. When you're signed into Chrome, your suggestions get smarter across all your devices. So let's say you visit a website on the desktop that starts with the letter N. Then in your Omnibox on your Android device, you type the letter N, and that website will appear as a suggestion. Now that saves a lot of typing.
Based on a browser user history, we can predict with a high level of accuracy where a user is likely to go when they type a letter in the Omnibox. For instance, when a user who often visits youtube.com types Y in the Omnibox, we can start loading and rendering the youtube.com page. So by the time they actually click on the Omnibox suggestion, the page has already been loaded. Of course, minimizing bandwidth usage is a concern for most mobile users. So we decided to turn on the feature by default only when you're connected to a Wi-Fi network.
Chrome's core design principle is that you shouldn't have to think about our UI. Our UI shouldn't distract you when you're trying to ignore it, and at the same time, you shouldn't have to hunt for it when you need it. For example, Chrome for Android's toolbar, while minimal, still gives you direct access to the most important functions of a browser: search, navigation, and tab switching. We've approached the design of Chrome for Android with the idea that, despite smaller devices, people want to do more with their browsers, and we want to make that experience as easy and delightful as possible.
Desktop browsers don't constrain the number of tabs you can have open. We thought, why should a mobile browser have artificial limits? Now, with Chrome for Android, you can open and browse with unlimited tabs. To do this, we had to manage the balance between keeping all tabs live at all times and the limited resources on the mobile device. So we freeze a tab when it goes to the background, and we fade it back in when you make it live without disrupting the page content.
We were now faced with the challenge of displaying an unlimited number of tabs on your phone. To prevent the cluttering, we decided to show all the web pages as a stack so we can see them all at once, pinch to see a specific one, or flip through them with a swipe of a finger. Because we took advantage of the hardware acceleration, we could show quick animations for all tabs interactions. So you get an idea of what just happened, and you don't get lost.
So for tablets, we really wanted to provide users with the traditional desktop feel of Chrome tabs, but optimized for touch-based interactions. To accommodate large numbers of tabs, we need to let them scroll and stack at the edge of the screen. And this is great, because you can drag the stack, or you can tap to expand it, and you can easily find the tab you're looking for. We wanted to make tab switching super easy for users to do using side gestures. So on Chrome for Android, you can use your thumb on the side of the screen, and you can easily change tabs, and you can do it without lifting your hand off the device.
Many websites are not optimized for mobile browsers. Desktop sites can often have small links that can be difficult to touch, especially when they're very close together. In Chrome for Android, we wanted to make navigating these sites easier, so we introduced the link preview feature. With the link preview feature, if there are many small links close together and we're not sure which one you intended to touch, we'll show you a zoomed-in view of all the surrounding links, letting you quickly and easily choose the one that you wanted. This way, you can always navigate to where you want to go without constantly zooming in and out.
Long, text-heavy pages can be especially hard to pass on the phone. We've introduced mobile-optimized Find in Page to make it easy to find what you're looking for. Just like on desktop, Chrome for Android highlights instances of the words you're searching for on the page. To make things easier on small phone screens, we've introduced a translucent sidebar where you can slide up and down through results quickly, especially useful on a page with a lot of matches.
Have you ever rushed away from your computer and wished that you'd remembered to send yourself those directions that you just looked up? Or maybe that long article that you didn't have a chance to read? When designing Chrome for Android, we thought, what if you could step away from your laptop, even close the lid, and still have access to your tabs, with each tab's browsing history on your mobile phone or tablet? Now you can. When you sign into Chrome on your desktop, and Chrome for Android on your mobile phone or tablet, you can have access to all your open tabs across all your devices, creating a completely continuous browsing experience.
Sometimes you want to guarantee that a document like a boarding pass or a concert ticket is available to you on your Android device, even if you don't have internet connection. When you sign into Chrome for Android, it is paired with your desktop browser. choose any page, and the document, including text and pictures, will be downloaded to your Android device, available even when you're offline.
Now that you've heard about the speed, simplicity, and sign-in features of Chrome for Android, why don't you give it a try?